Yeah. Struggles to take steps off the guy. No. It's a huge mountain.
Oh my god, he's going Falcon.
Wow. He's trying to show Chris. Okay.
He's going to get bodied harder than Chris got bodied.
Real talk. All right, so why this is happening, you have to know Kells and you have to know Overly. So I'm pretty sure what happened. I don't even have to hear the conversation or anything.
I don't know.
Kells is basically trying to make, like, show Overly that he's better than him, at, like, even with Falcon. Whenever Chris loses to Kells, he
complains
a lot. And in the most obnoxious ways, like saying that Kells isn't good, that he just gets lucky and all this stuff. Like, sure, sometimes, but consistently wins everything in the Midwest. He's a skillful player. So, oh my goodness. Sorry, that looked better than anything Chris did. Okay, not anything, but Kells did.
Here's what makes me mad. Kells is so, he doesn't care, like, to an extent. Where's your freaking Final Destination Game 1 with a Falcon?
Did they even stage strike? Did they just say, like, I'll play Falcon? You want to go to FD?
I hope they didn't stage strike, because that would have been embarrassing to see.
I was too busy talking about Chris.
I hope Kelly gets four-stocked. I hope Kelly gets four-stocked, dude. This is rough. This is really bad.
Still alive for the moment.
Kelly's doing what? No, actually, Shinobi's doing. Shinobi's doing literally what Kells does to Aureli every week. week.
Yes.
Kelly's doing the exact same thing Aureli does.
Oh.
Oh my god. He misses the easiest follow-ups.
All right, that'll be a stock. No,
oh, he's up. He's okay. Okay.
Yeah, that's a stock.
I wanted to see
Kells
Kelly drop that.
Size relief. Oh, I don't think. Okay. Yeah, JV canceled. I was like, he doesn't even care about JV canceling, but he does. Gets the strongest knee and then just kills himself.
Kelly's trolling. Oh,
to the
my
grave.
God.
He has a whole set. I don't think he cares. He's staying Falcon.
Oh, what a dick.
Oh my goodness. He's not even trying his Pikachu.
What a dick.
I think he's trying to get more games off Shinobi than Chris did with Falcon.
Oh!
That's the one you can tech. Oh, and Shinobi gets back. My
Fox
goodness.
Is broken, dude.
No, not that time.
Oh my god, Kelly looks back and says, that's how you do it.
So, if you haven't guessed, this is a lot of just trash talking.
This is just beef.
This is Aureli versus Kelly.
This is literally just Aureli versus Kelly.
Shinobi is just caught in the middle right now.
He's like, I don't know what's going on, man.
That was actually a really sick, like, catcher.
See,
Kelly's is starting to heat up a little bit.
You know what my problem with that down air was? It covered nothing. It didn't cover Tekken Place, and it didn't cover Tekken.
So, it did something.
It didn't do anything!
Did it hit?
No, it didn't. It just whipped.
Okay, well, I don't know.
Oh my god, I'm so mad.
Maybe
that
it's
Kelly's
a bait. And I'm not talking about the Luigi player.
I'm so mad. This is tilting me.
See, dude, what is this? Kells is actually doing this right
now.
I'm
so mad right now.
I hope he doesn't finish the set. Like this. Yeah. If he wins this game, oh my god.
I hope
it's gonna go straight to his head.
I'm the best Falcon in the Midwest.
What do you think, man? Falcon's so stupid. I feel my best Kelly impersonation.
The worst is, like, in PM, Kells was actually playing Falcon for a bit in certain matchups, like against Bowser when Chris was playing Bowser. So there were some tournaments that Chris lost to Kells as Falcon in PM. Like,
oh my god.
But yeah, those guys have a lot of history, and that's all that's going on in the stream. I'm sorry you're caught in the middle of all this. Hope you can see some cool
stuff. Nobody wanted to see this.
I thought we were seeing Fox Dittos, maybe a Falco. I thought if Kells was going to troll, he'd do it with Pikachu, not Falcon, but...
Literally, nobody wanted to see this, dude.
Nobody. But honestly, what we're witnessing is the difference in, like, mental fortitude and how that affects the game. Is where Kells objectively isn't a better Falcon, right? So what's happening is he's, like, stronger, like, mentally. Like, he's keeping his cool in certain places and, like, keeping his wits about him. Where I don't want to say the nerves were getting to Chris, but, like, he definitely felt the pressure. And, like, Shinobi felt it, too. And you can just – that's almost just the difference between players is, like, how calm you can stay under pressure.
Kells does have that top player aura about him.
Yeah, hell yeah. I was talking to Hindog recently, and he says that's literally the only reason he, like, takes sets off Kells is because he's very mentally strong, and he keeps his calm, even if he's down, if he's up, or whatever.
My goodness, that rap boost.
Oh my god. I hate Kelly.
But that's what I mean about he's not getting pressure. He's not going into Fox's stuff. He's just keeping his calm. He's doing his mix-ups. He's just playing the game.
I'm so
and
mad.
He's not reading too much into any stock or any game in particular. He's just playing.
The difference between me and Sweet is that he'll actually try to analyze this. I'm just mad right now. I'm just really mad.
You can pull something out of every game. Did you watch it's Revival of Melee number 1, the grand finals, I think of it.
Yeah.
I think it's that tournament. It's actually Falcon Dittos between Mango and Mewtwo King. They split the tournament. So, like, there's a winner's final set, and then when they get back, like, it actually wasn't put on YouTube for a while. I don't know if it's still there. But it's literally just Falcon Dittos between, nobody wanted to watch that. Except, that was, like, the first set you ever saw, like, Mewtwo King chain-grabbing Falcon and Falcon Dittos.
Yeah.
And, like, learning that that's a real thing. Like, you learn stuff even if it's not their main character. Like, his Falcon, I gotta say, is actually looking kinda hot. Looking crisp. Some of the stuff, the combos he's on.
I'm not gonna deny that Kels' Falcon's good.
Like, he didn't do the up air knee combo that Chris has done a couple times today. But, like, he's done Rapidus knee, and, like, he's done the bread and butters. The ones that matter. But he is, like, kind of getting bopped here.
Like I was saying, I'm not gonna deny that Kels' Falcon's good, alright? But I hope he loses. Because I was talking to him earlier about the Peach matchup, and I was like, dude, what do I do with Sheep? And this is he looked at me with his bored Kelly look, and he said, yo, just go Falcon. I'm just like, no! What the? I'm tilted just talking
Kels.
About it.
Oh no. Kels is listening to your story in Suicides, laughing too hard. Oh my goodness.
Oh my god.
Kels just grabbed him and made his stock disappear.
I'm so mad.
If O'Reilly was doing that kind of stuff, like, he would have won the set.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it was all just kind of nerves where, like, he's.
Ooh! Hits him with the mango!
My goodness. That's going to be a gift cast.
What a gobble!
I shot that shit. Oh my goodness.
It's time to gobble!
Wow.
No, that was sick. That was actually sick.
Wow, the Randall up smash. Just charging it. Damn. Alright, back to Dreamland? Didn't they already play here? No. No, it's Pokemon Stadium, right? Started on FD, then it went to... Pokemon Stadium.
I wonder if Kelly's gonna call him out on his Shine spells, because he does it every time.
It's hard, actually, to do that.
Like, I know what she can do against the Shine spell is just drop down with the bear.
Yeah, so like, that's the best punish, is like, you just go hit them in their shine while they're just sitting there.
This is tilting me. The fact that Kels is keeping it close.
With Falcon? So bad. That's just good player syndrome. It's like, he's not actually winning with the character, he's just outplaying the player and being...
What an up air. And...
If he re-grabbed the edge, it would've been a good up air.
You know what tilts me the most about Kelly? He always looks bored. He never looks happy to be here.
Sometimes he looks happy. You just have to, like, kill him in a unique way he hasn't seen before.
Yeah, and then he laughs.
Yeah, he's like, oh my god.
He either laughs or he does the eye roll, where he just leans back in his chair further than the chair itself allows. And he's just like, ugh, it's so stupid.
Anyways. Wave shine up smash. He's still alive. He needed to do more than that. He needed like two more shines. Doesn't turn around.
Oh my god.
That'll do that.
So look, he did it, dude. He's just like, ugh.
Oh! He actually just didn't want to save
Kels. Oh, he laughed that time. He laughed that time.
See? You just have to kill Kels in a weird way, and then he laughs. He smiles.
Oh my god. Invincible.
I mean, this is Falcon we're talking about, and he's not out of this. A couple knees. As long as he doesn't, like, get actually pushed off stage right now.
The funny thing is...
Nair out of shield? Come on.
Shinobi's doing the exact same thing Kels does to O'Reilly.
Play Fox?
Yeah, just wave shot him across stage and make him really tilt.
I do that too, and too. I don't think he tilts, though. I think it just, like, solidifies his anger in, like, wanting to destroy you. One, no, still not enough. That's you need to do like five more. That will do. There's no way out of that. That's the first set.
I wonder if he's going to switch. I wonder if now that his money is actually on the line, he'll switch.
I think Chris walked away. He's gone. He doesn't care anymore. But I think he would have liked to see that Kells didn't do any better. He didn't, like, do 3-2.
Oh, Fox does. Let's go. All
right. Okay, cool. Serious games.
Finally.
So Kells is playing blue. Shinobi's playing green.
Yeah, no. You can't take in place for some Kells. He'll always go for that up there.
He does reaction stuff, so yeah. It's like, you don't have many options.
That's it.
People don't realize that about Kells. It's like, everything he's doing is literally just reacting. Like, sometimes he'll just stand in place and just wait for you to do something. And
he's
then
such a strong player, and he never really... Actually, no, I can't say that he doesn't choke. He chokes all the time. But...
He does choke sometimes.
But, in terms of keeping calm in sets where he... might not necessarily win 100%. He's really good at it. He doesn't tilt against players that he knows he can beat.
Yeah. Like, yeah, getting Kells on tilt is not a thing.
Really,
I don't think I've ever done it personally. Never. I mean, not that I've visually seen.
That was a down angled F tilt. That was really good. And he traded with the. He got burned a little bit, but it was fine because that's like minimal damage.
The only person that I see like tilting Kells. Was like Fruit Loop and Dark on a consistent basis. He also like would tilt against West Walls and like Axe and
but
stuff.
Kelly's actually infamous for making Dart tilt as well.
Yes, but Dart.
Oh my God, that was such the boom.
I love Dart. He's a great player. He's a good friend of mine. But he does have like a tilt problem where when he tilts, he's done.
Crush hits Dot Smash. Oh, let's go.
Shinobi's so good. He's
what
so
an
good.
Armada Shinobi.
So, do you think Kells is regretting the fact that he already threw a set away?
I think so.
Maybe he would have won it.
You notice how he's just sitting forward in his chair now instead of leaning back.
Yeah, he's
he cares now.
He might die here, though. Oh, wow. Full hop down air onto the platform. I like that solution. Because Shinobi was just camping, like, above him. And, like, shining come back.
Shinobi went for the Chicago.
Oh, this is it. Yeah, you're dead.
Do you know what the Chicago is?
What's the Chicago?
Charging an F-Smash for an edge guard.
Oh.
It only works on players from Chicago.
I've been trying to teach LSD to stop doing that.
It's really bad.
Yeah.
Just
I think he finally stopped, but like it took months and months. Like, dude, if you can charge it, you have time to not charge it.
Oh, yeah,
that's not going to kill.
Yeah, that's not going to kill, but...
5% before it kills.
Kelly's in a bad position.
Oh,
nice.
Edge cancels, gets out, gets the F-Smash. Oh, if he would have back-aired instead of grabbing an edge.
Yeah, Kelly went a little bit too far with that drill. I think he was going for the drill.
Wow!
Oh, wow. That's it.
No, it's not.
Oh, what? I'm gonna stop calling things.
Wow, he just won.
This is.
Scrappy. They both
this
won.
This is just.
That'll do.
Back air? Oh, up smash.
Shinobi's really good at those tech chases. I saw a match earlier. Somebody killed themselves like that. It was supposed to be a 2-0 by a Peach player, I want to say. And like he went Peach first game, and then second game he went Samus, and he was winning. And he start KO'd the opponent because it was Peach Dose first game. He start KO'd the other Peach off the top of Yoshi's, and like as Peach is dying off the top, he falls off the bottom and kills himself.
Yeah.
They handshake, walk away, and they come back a minute later and say no, they're gonna finish the set. I don't like to see that kind of stuff. Anyways, back to the game. Kells,
Lucky actually did that as well against Plump.
Against Plump in the crew battle, yeah.
That was hilarious.
But this was like a tournament set.
Nice pressure by Shinobi.
Keep playing up tilt.
Yeah.
Just wave shines.
I've never seen a wave shine like that.
I think Hax is actually been doing those. Instead of like jabbers.
That's it.
Damn, one of. Excuse my language. That's the very edge of the range where you kill. That's something Hax Money actually does. Like against somebody that falls down from shine, he doesn't jab reset because you can.
Yeah, he just keeps.
Yeah,
you keep shining. You just keep going.
Yeah. It's like, oh my God, that's such a good idea.
But it's hard. It's really hard.
I mean, once they're on the ground, that's the easy part. Rolls up.
Everything Hex does is just stupidly hard. Same with KJH. Both players just do really hard stuff.
Go big or go home. I don't know. Do the hard thing.
That's how you get the Giphy cap.
Yeah. Do the hard thing or don't bother playing.
Falling up air. Ooh, yes. That was actually such a fast reaction.
And interesting choice. They both fought for that cliff.
Nice shot on shield. That was actually very perfect.
Kells doesn't want to go to that edge. He finally does.
Fire stalls.
He gave up the back. He didn't want to do that. Great falling up. We're back to Pokemon Stadium. The neutral Sage. And not this, the janky fire transformation. I thought he was going to forward tilt. Kind of go forward tilt. Interesting. He tried to jab that one. Just stays out of range.
Back air. This should be an edge guard. Nope.
I didn't like the fact that Shinobi walked forward before doing the double shine attempts. If you just shine and, like, double shine and, damn, nice.
Wow.
If you just double shine in place, Fox always goes behind you. And because he walked forward first, like, the second shine just automatically whiffed. He would have had a double shine, which is basically death.
Not on Fox. There's still a chance to recover. But on Falco, yes. That's
no, it's the other way around. Falco can
really?
Side B on stage still. If he smash the eyes up and jumps at him at the very perfect frame. But Fox is guaranteed to have to
this combo.
Upbeat.
Oh, this shine. God,
he should have Armada shined it, honestly.
I think Shinobi has to be more honest with that.
I need to teach Kells the Armada shining because I don't see him do very much.
That's the fourth pulse.
It's the combo. That wasteland. Yeah, he's been getting it before. But
that's not gonna kill.
Up smash beats jab. Who would have thunk? That was the West Ball's approach. Jump, double jump, come down with an aerial. He does that so much. Like with Falco, he'll like jump, double jump immediately, and just come down with a down air. And that's last stock. Shinobi can still do this.
Shinobi's actually not at a percent where
something,
a stray aerial will kill him.
I want to say something Kells could have done but didn't do. When Shinobi was Firefox stalling and Kells was invincible, as Fox, you can run up and just stand in the burn, and it puts them into hit lag, which makes their invincibility less, and then you just stand in the burn and then you shine in the last frame before they grab. And there's nothing they can do about it because you're invincible. I thought Kells was going to do that, but he didn't.
Kelly's looking real serious.
Yeah, he doesn't want to lose. Game two, he almost loses his stock right away. Shield, was that a shield drop down?
It was.
Down B? Holy crap.
Well, shield drop shine's actually not as hard as
I mean, it's not hard,
people,
but it's like, it's. I think that's the next, that's the meta. It's like, that's going to be the next
It's
thing.
Actually faster than shine out shield.
Exactly. So, like, I think people are going to start doing shield drop shine into, like, waveland stuff.
Yeah.
Like, it's going to.
You can shield drop shine perfectly and then just do an aerial out of it. Like,
oh, because you land on the platform again. Oh my goodness, I'm going into the training room after today.
I've seen Falcos do shield drop, shine, platform cancel bear. That's disgusting.
Yeah. Wow. Anyways, back to the game, that's pretty even. Kells gets him off with a nice backer, up throw backer. And that's probably gonna be a stock.
Shouts to Webs. Nice backer.
Nice backer. So I guess another part of the new meta is like this mangle, and Shinobi did it. Wow. So basically Shinobi did what I said. Instead of using a shine, he used a down smash.
Yeah.
Firefox stalling when your opponent is invincible is not safe, just because of the hit lag.
Stalling in general, like Shino stalling isn't safe when your opponent's invincible. They can always just grab ledge.
Yeah. Well, at least with Shino stalling, you can see that, like, they have their back turned and they're, like, gonna wave dash.
Right.
But with that Firefox, they just walk up to you, like, I don't know. And you've already committed to it at that point. He's gonna go straight at the edge, get Randall. Even if you got edge hard, you got Randall. So that was the 100% choice to do. I feel like Shinobi should have seen that, like, that was the only angle to do and, like, just let it back go.
Shy Guy slowed him down a bit.
I actually hate Shy Guys for that reason.
They're the worst. I think
these players are respecting each other an awful lot.
So many
hop down here. I thought. Two.
Well, that's Sheik.
We might see some of that.
Oh god, I hope Kells doesn't play Sheik.
No, he probably won't. Shinobi has probably a crap ton of Sheik.
Sheik match is probably amazing.
Yeah.
All that there's the Armada shine.
That was Shinobi, not Kells. I'm like, I don't have to teach him that, but I do. I do a dude.
Nice angle. Wow.
Yeah. Kells must have like just thought he was going straight.
Another good angle.
Yeah, those
He's gonna side B. No.
So I think, ooh, good back air, getting the other way.
Way too low.
I feel like
a sweet spotter.
Kells is losing a little bit to the new age, like, recovery.
Oh, that's it.
That's just going to do it.
Oh, my God.
Suddenly, Shinobi's up 2-0 in Grand Finals, second set.
In every set, in every Fox Note, everyone gets one of those. You never catch him again. At least a respectable player.
Hopefully, yeah.
Huh?
It's 2-0.
2-1.
2-1?
2-1 okay. Shinobi. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I'm sorry.
2-1.
2-1, I'm sorry. Okay. All right, good stuff, Kelly. I don't want to see a 30 happen. Not after he, like, if he got 30'd with his Fox after doing 3-1 with his Falcon, I don't think I'd be able to PR him number one after that.
Shinobi's played really well.
Oh, he's still alive.
That's it.
Yeah, oh. He's still alive.
You're better at this Fox Ditto stuff than I am.
I've done it a lot. Oh, yeah. Classic bait.
So much footsies going on.
Oh, he went for the Armada Shine. He doesn't have a double jump.
He did it on the third pulse instead of the fourth, which is why he got hit.
Interesting. I don't even think about it as pulses. But
there's no hitbox right before Fox.
Yes, there's a 10-frame window.
Right. Which is actually super generous in Melee standards.
Yeah, like, win a game of all, like, frame one and two-frame inputs, like, a 10-frame window is... You might have, well, have years. I'm gonna go to the edge, yeah. That was just obvious.
Nice. Okay. Wow, Kelly's just on him.
Yeah, Kelly doesn't like to lose. I think he has gone, like, stepped up from Super Saiyan, like, 1, now he's at Super Saiyan 3. You know, he just skipped the Ascended Saiyan phase. He's like, I'm not messing around anymore. I want to win.
What is his profile picture? Actually...
I don't like those roll edgeguards that he's been doing. Or, like, Shinobi just, like, does a like, Mewtwo King angle to get on stage and puts his rolls. It doesn't work. He's still winning, though. I mean...
So, Rilly's profile picture on Facebook is Majin Vegeta.
Yeah, and Kells,
and Kells is Super Saiyan 3.
He
changed it after he saw that.
There you go.
Wow.
That's how you do it.
That's not safe.
Yeah.
Invincible. Yeah, you're right.
I mean,
fire stalls are not safe.
But also, it's because, like, because the fire hits the opponent, it adds, yeah, it, like, reduces your invincibility because of the hit lag. Oh, he tried to reset him.
He wanted that nasty down air.
He has to be careful. If he loses the stock right now, it's not much of a lead.
Oh,
he uses his double jump. Barely gets around
just
that.
Just misses it. I think
barely
this should be the stock, yeah.
He gets that laser. So,
Kelly's potentially on his tournament stock here.
Yeah, he's got to do something.
This is what happens when you play Falcon Set 1.
Yeah. I mean, if there's a way to teach Kells to not mess around, this is it.
Oh,
and good on Shinobi
this is how it
if
starts.
He's going to do it. Oh, Kells doesn't even play with that. He's like, oh no. This could be it.
Oh no.
Okay, he gets down, but he's off stage.
Oh, what?
Oh, okay.
What a jab. What the heck?
That's the Kells luck a little bit. He doesn't get up tilted. Oh.
I don't think he wanted the back throw.
He's playing really safe right now. He's staying in the middle of the stage. He's not going to go to that edge.
Oh, Shinobi. Oh. Oh.
That's it.
That's it.
Yeah. Whew, all right. Game 5. Second set of Grand Finals.
All right, Kelly.
All right, so this is for all the marbles. All of the marbles comes down to this. Really shaking his head at me in the audience. We all know who Aurelie's rooting for right now.
Now I feel like they're gonna go to Fountain.
What if it's FD?
I wouldn't do that.
What if they just go back to Stadium?
Kelly's a chain grabber.
Fountain of Dreams, it could be.
Yeah.
That is an option.
I did call Fountain.
Ooh, it is Fountain. Okay.
I got 50 on black. Let's go.
Which one? Is Kelly black?
Oh,
I mean,
not that way. It was like a gambling reference, man.
Yeah, but I mean, like, if I'm gonna if I'm gonna take that bet, like, I have to know which one I'm betting for.
You're right. I got 10 on red.
Kells does the very, very... Oh, he lets him back, though. He's falling for the mangles, but he's... No, Kelly,
wow.
Just roll. Come on, Kelly.
Yeah, I got it.
Sorry, I'm rooting for Kelly.
I mean, yeah, Chicago.
Yeah, I have to. He's my boy. Legend of Towner.
Nice back here.
Not looking like grand finals.
So
they're both really nervous.
Nice.
That's the stock. That's the first stock goes to Shinobi. Kells has to
this
bring
is it.
Back.
I mean,
he does it again.
Yeah. Shinobi's just.
No, Kelly Smith.
The man.
All
the myth.
So now we're going to see.
Kelly Smith.
We're going to see A game Kells, or we're going to see choke Kells. It's going to one of the, there's no in between right now. Yeah. All right.
This isn't that big of a deficit. Stock's not a lead.
No, not in this matchup. I mean, it is a lead, but it's not.
It's not insurmountable. Yeah, insurmountable.
Yeah, I was going to use the exact same word. I'm glad you used it. I'm on the edge of my seat right now.
Tech in? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. That's the, oh, I thought that was Kells' drill, but Shinobi shined. He's going to go knockdown.
Oh my god, is this happening? You know why Dark Atma didn't enter today?
Because
he didn't want to fight Kells.
Like,
I can't believe this is happening.
It's not. I think Kells might still be able to pull this back. I see him warming up a little bit.
Shinobi sets such low percent on this. Like, he still has 3 stocks left.
Yeah, but, I mean, any shine like this. Like, this could be an edge guard. Oh no, he doesn't get enough save. See, it's all about
Shinobi
first
choking.
Hits. It's not about percent, it's about first hits.
I think Shinobi's choking.
I don't know. That up smash didn't look like a choke to me.
Yeah.
That looked very deadly.
Oh,
he just goes down there. Now suddenly Kells is on the last
don't
stock he'll ever get today.
I thought Shinobi was going to go for the up B stall again and then get punished for like the 5th time.
Kells does the roll recovery again.
Oh.
He goes high and that's the Armada
that's
shine.
It!
That's the turn.
Shinobi beats Kells.
I mean, if there's anything Kells should take away from the set,
Shinobi,
it's that he shouldn't go Falcon. He
Shinobi
shouldn't sandbag.
Takes House of Pain 10.